First of all, the world has finally assumed that there should be a decarbonization and that there is no way of having our sons, daughters and grandsons living in a decent world if there is no push on decarbonizing the economy. And all the studies say that there is no way of fulfilling the Paris Agreement targets without hydrogen. Hydrogen is absolutely necessary because it is a source of energy which can be clean and which can substitute existing carbon emitting fuels. Today, on top of that, generating hydrogen is both green hydrogen through electrolyzers is both technically much more viable than it was before and economically much more viable than it was before. Electrolyzers capex have gone down, electricity price has gone down, and those are the two main factors of the cost of green hydrogen. So this is the second factor making the hydrogen boom as important as it is today. And not just in Chile, this is happening in Europe as well and around the world. And there are several activities where hydrogen can be used as a substitute, as I was mentioned before, of existing CO2 emitting fuels. Starting from the very simple transportation activities and going to the so-called heart of eight sectors. And the heart of eight sectors are typically using natural gas, diesel, or even heavy fuel oil, and are sectors emitting a lot of CO2 and where an investment in new technologies can transition those sectors to a green or CO2-free path, which is what hydrogen will allow.
Well, we believe that as investors, technology is now ripe and available to make what was very difficult technically in the past feasible now. And more importantly, we're getting much closer to economic sustainability in the coming years. Second, the green transition is that the world is going through to meet the net zero emissions is going to be a key driver. We will need all our efforts to maximize the ability to meet these objectives, and hence green hydrogen is key to meeting those goals. And finally, green hydrogen is a very important input into other industries that are involved in green transition in Chile, namely the copper and lithium mining activities.
Well, hydrogen has generated headlines for a long time. However, today, we see the conditions are in place to advance in an accelerated way. Countries are rethinking their growth and setting the basis for their post-COVID economies. The Build Back Better movement has put green hydrogen as one of those core industries to be accelerated. Various leading countries have generated important stimuli packages around this sector. For example, Germany 9 billion, France 7 billion, Japan branding itself the Hydrogen Society, in addition to Australia, Morocco and Spain. This is a race in an even playing field. But Chile's advantages, surplus in solar energy and eolic energy, help it surpass the current green premium and position itself as a hidden giant and a global player. Chile launched a national green hydrogen strategy with an ambitious goal: to become a leading hydrogen exporter, targeting 25 gigawatts of electrolysis capacity, and to become the cheapest in prices in the world by 2030.